Hello, hi there everyone, Abhishek here, back with another video. This video is going to be about MCA at PES University. A lot of you have asked me this question, how to take admission in MCA branch in PES. This video is a detailed video about PES. I'm going to cover everything about PES, when the admission starts, when the admission closes, when the classes start, how is the placement, how is the internship, everything I'm going to cover in this video. So sit back, relax, watch this complete video to know everything about MCA and PES University. So let's go. So in this video I'm going to cover everything about MCA and PES. What is the fee structure, what is the interview process, what question they ask in interview, how to submit certification, everything I'm going to cover in this video. So sit back, relax, watch this complete video to know everything about MCA and PES. Okay, let me go in detail. So PES is actually different from other colleges. I have created a 20 minute video on this. You can watch this video. It is really different from other colleges. You can watch the complete video to understand it. Some snippets are like all of your exam are computer based and hybrid, so that is there, and all the syllabus are up to date. Like every new batch comes, they update the syllabus. So a lot of small things are there in PES. You should watch this video to know everything about PES and how it is different from other colleges. Things you should know before joining PES. So every new batch comes, they create and update the syllabus. So this time there has been huge changes in syllabus, and let me briefly explain the syllabus to you. So PES is expecting master's students to have decent knowledge in their core subject. There is no basics of operating system. It is going to be advanced operating system only, system design only. So you must have the knowledge of operating system beforehand. They are not going to teach HTML, CSS. They are just going to start with JavaScript. So that is there. It is basically about student must have basic knowledge about their subjects beforehand, and they are going to teach in advance. So they are expecting student must come with a basic knowledge of one language, at least a C language. They are not going to teach this language. They are just going to cover data structure directly. So that is there. About the placements, so I'm the placement coordinator of my department, so I'm collecting data of the placement. So give me more time, I'll create a detailed video about placements in PES. Let me briefly tell you, no FANG company will come for the MCA. Like if FANG comes, mostly hire BTech student over the MCA student. So that is there. So don't expect FANG, but placement from the PES is around 6 to 25 LPA. So that is there. No FANG is there, but that is decent for the MCA student. You will get internship from the college itself. Like many companies comes for the internship program, and generally what happens, you have to do internship and get the PPA from the same college. So that is there, and internship must be within the state. So that is there in PES criteria. So let's talk about fee structure in MCA. So fee is around 5 lakh for PESSAT student and 2.5 lakh for PGCET student. Yeah, state scholarship is there, so there is difference. There is around 240 seats for MCA, so 100 seats are reserved for the PGCET batch and rest is for PESSAT student. There is scholarship program in PES. If you are top 14% of your batch, you will get MRD 50% cutoff on your fee. So that is there, you will get cash from that 50% cutoff. So that is good part. So let's talk about deadlines of the admissions. So admissions start from January to July. It goes like that, and batch generally start from beginning of September. But the good thing is you can submit your migration certificate. If you haven't received a hard copy of your previous degree, you can submit it by till next January or February before ESA comes. So that is good. There are many batchmates who told me they have to drop because they didn't have degree with them, hard copy. So they didn't come to the college, but they could have done this. To get into PES, there is three different ways. There is PESSAT, there is PGCET, and there is management. Management I have no idea about. So let's talk about PESSAT and PGCET. PESSAT can be given by anyone in the India, and PGCET is mostly can be given by only Karnataka people. So there is a huge fee difference between PGCET and PESSAT student, but in class there is no difference. One thing is there, if you are from Karnataka, you don't need to wait for PGCET. You can take admission from PESSAT only, and if you scored good and can reserve seat from PESSAT to PGCET batch, fee will be given to you back. One student is there, Keithi Prabhu. She has scored rank 3 in PGCET. and she took admission from PESSAT only. So she got seat of PGCET feedback of PESSAT, which is 5 lakhs. She is paying only 2.5 lakh for the MCA. So that is there. If you are from Karnataka, you can do this. This can be changed in future. I am not sure about it, but this she have done it. To get admission through PGCET, you must rank under 300. Again, it depends on the category, but under 300 is safe side for the PES. Coming to PESSAT, who are not from Karnataka, all over the India can give PESSAT. You have to go to the website and fill the PESSAT form. 1000 something is the fee of the form, and then you can allot your seat for the interview. There will be one by one interview with the faculty of PES only. 30 to 40 minute interview they are going to do. What they ask in interviews? So interviews, they are going to do your background check. What is your studies? Where you are from and what projects you have done so far and what are your achievements so far. So they will ask this question, then after that they will ask questions from logical reasoning, which can be verbally solved, and the questions will be around basics to medium. They will ask basic question from your bachelor degrees. If you have done BCA, they are going to ask which subject you have been doubt in your bachelor's, because they want to know if you have studied or not. If you have studied, which subject you have studied. Based on those subjects, they are going to ask questions. What questions they ask from me, I'm going to tell you. How to access pointer, pointing to pointer, how to reference, how to dereference, how to pass it as parameter. And other question was, what is pointer function? What is use of pointer functions? Difference between IP address 4 and IP address 6, which is valid IP address here. What is waterfall model? Basic about OS operating system. SQL queries for CRUD operations, they asked me. How many times the condition of the loop was checked? Even some simple questions they ask, like in Python, how you can print string 100 times without using loop. So this is simple question. What is switch statement? What is use of switch statements? These all questions they asked from me. They asked about project, what project I have did and how I did and what are the challenges were there and why I chose that project. So one more question they asked, why you are joining PES, why not other college, and why leaving your state and coming to Bangalore only. One thing is there, I didn't answer everything, like some of the question I got stuck, so I just told the teacher like I don't know the answer, I will work on it. That is there. If you don't know anything, just tell them, there is no issue with that. You will get the email of the result, did you pass or not. If you pass or selected, within 7 days you will have to pay around 1,10,000, which is, this can be changed. So 10,000 is there, which is non-refundable caution money, and in a week you will have to pay around 1,10,000 for blocking your seat there. After blocking the seat, you will have to wait till August. Around that time they start the document verification. You will get the email about the details of the document verification with the dates and all. You will have to show up there with original documentation and remaining demand draft. All the instructions will be there in email, so don't worry about it. About document verification, many of us have issue that college don't give us hard copy of the degree, or don't have degree around that time, or your college is doing delay in degree certificate. So you will get time till January or Feb to submit your final documents of bachelor's. Digitally signed, they are not going to accept. It must be seized, officially signed by university people. So application done, interview done, fee done, joining done. After that, there will be two batches running, which is PGCET batch and PESSAT. PESSAT batch will start early. They will get advantage because they start teaching PESSAT student early, then PGCET batch joins later. Because PGCET exam result comes late, so they start PESSAT student classes early, so they get the advantage. I hope I have covered all your doubts regarding MCA and PES. So yeah, come join PES, stay connected, meet you soon there. And if you want mock interviews, you can check in description or comment section. I'll be posting there, or you can comment if you are interested. Thank you so much for watching this video. Abhishek here.